Jesus, for an opportunity. We thank you for the gift of life. Come on, somebody, we thank Jesus because it is because of Jesus that we are loved this morning. So many people have died. So many people are sick. So many people have lost loved ones. So many people are struggling, dying. They don't know what to do. But us, Jesus, have given us another chance. We thank Jesus. It's not because of our strength. It's not because that we want. It's not because we have done something good for him, but because of his mercy. That is why we say thank you, Jesus. We want to thank you, Lord, for another day, another night, another evening, another hour, another moment, or being in your presence. Indeed, it is a privilege to be in the presence of God. Hallelujah. I want to share something about Christian unity in truth and in love. Christian unity. We are in the end times. In this end time, the Lord is working with in a revival, returning the church into its oneness, returning the church into its unity, the true unity, the original truth, the original church. Hallelujah. The believers of the old times, how did they work? When we see today, we believers, we are divided. We are fighting one another. We are struggling with one another. We are backbiting. You know, it is not good at all. Look at the church in the whole world. Everyone is just, people, we want to tear each other apart. People are fighting. You see, ministers are fighting with one another. But why are they fighting? Why are we struggling? Why are we backbiting? Why are we judging one another? We've never been called to judge one another. We were never been called, you know, to criticize one another. We are measuring anointing. So and so has the strongest anointing. So and so cannot move with so and so. So and so they cannot minister with so and so. Why? Because there is something that has entered into the church of Christ. And we're in the days of the last days. Whatever is happening in the world right now, I want everybody of us to think about it. What if you have just fought with your fellow believer? What if you have just fought or, you know, you're backbiting and then the rapture, it happens. Or you get an accident. Or coronavirus takes you unaware. This is the time each one of us have to go back on our knees. Whatever has happened in the past, it has happened. We have to work together. The Lord is looking for the true believers, the true ministers who are not working or serving him for selfish motives, but because they want to win souls for him. Because we feel bad, we feel sorry for the sinners, for the lost, you know, for the lost souls. Hallelujah. The Lord is coming. He's not coming for the divided church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus is coming for the united church. The church that he died for at the cross. Hallelujah. Amen. Not the divided church. You see, this church is saying, if you can't join our church, you cannot go to heaven. This one is saying, you must join our church. This one, you must join this ministry. This one is, this was not like this in the beginning. This was not like this in the times of the apostles. But there is a spirit that has come into the church that is trying to tear off the church, to tear off believers, to divide the church of Christ. But Jesus is coming for one church. According to Ephesians 5:27, Jesus is coming to take the church that he died for to the Lord Almighty, our Father. Hallelujah. He's not coming for this denomination or that denomination or the other denomination, but one church. Hallelujah. Only holiness and righteousness. is going to take people to the kingdom of God, not the denomination. Because most people today will say, because I'm in this denomination, I'm ready for the rapture. Who told you? This one say, because my church is the only church that is preparing souls for the rapture. Who told us? We are lying. Hallelujah. We are becoming selfish. This is not why we are called to serve. We are called to serve God in unity. We are serving the church. We are serving the souls. Hallelujah. Every one of us, we are supposed to work together, to join hand in hand, to harvest. Hallelujah. In this end time, in the revival, this one says, oh, you cannot make it to heaven unless you join this ministry. Who told us? Hallelujah. This is so disappointing. Every time I hear something like that, I just feel like I want to cry. The church is dividing. The so-called, we are giving ourselves names. Me, I'm a bishop so-and-so. Me, I'm a reverend so-and-so. Me, I'm pastor so-and-so. Me, I'm evangelist so-and-so. All these titles are going to just end up here. We're not going to type with the titles in the kingdom of God. Only holiness and true righteousness is the one going to take everyone to heaven. Without it, according to Hebrews 12:14. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hebrews 12:14. Why are we fighting? What does the scripture say? Follow people with all men. Follow peace with all men. And holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Pursue peace with all people and holiness, without which no one will see the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Pursue peace. Follow peace. There is nothing like, oh, follow this denomination, or follow this church, or follow this ministry, follow this pastor, follow this bishop. No. Follow peace with all men. Meaning we have to love one another. We have to be in love, complete love, without hypocrisy. So many of us, we are full of hypocrisy. We say, me, I'm fine. Me, I'm better than this one. Me, I'm better than this one. With self-righteousness. Why can't we allow the Lord to judge us? Him alone can judge humanity with a righteous judgment. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. We are lying ourselves. We are becoming hypocrites. We are hiding ourselves in these clothes we are wearing. The Bible says in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 9, that the heart is desperately wicked. Who can know it? I, the Lord, test the heart. I search the mind. Hallelujah. Even to give every man a gift according to the fruit of their doing, the doing of their work. Whatever we do, we have to do it wholeheartedly. No, we're not doing it for man, but we're doing it for God. If we are called to love one another, then let us love one another in truth, not in hypocrisy. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. The Lord is not divided. God is not divided. He's working together. He wants to work with us. Us who have been called. Us who have been chosen. We're dividing each other. We are fighting for money, church, you know, the finances in the church. We are fighting for the souls. This pastor is telling, you know, his members, don't go to this church. If you ever go there, don't come back. You see? So the church means it belongs to the pastor. The church belongs to Jesus. The souls belong to Jesus. Where did the pastor get the souls? Brethren, hallelujah.
Amen.
Where did the bishop get the souls? Because all souls were brought to this church by God. And it's only God who has the right to do whatever he wants to do with the souls. No one has ever died for the souls. For any soul at all. And no one will ever die for any soul. Only Jesus died for us. And he died for all of us. So our work, we're supposed to unite, not to scatter. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not supposed to divide, but to unite. People are fighting against each other. The money, you know, the tithe, you know, the seed, the souls, the believers, even they start fighting against one another. Even the pastor ministers, you find this one, they love this one, they don't love this one. This one, because it dresses nice, they in the morning when you come to church, even if you come late, they remove the other one who came in the morning earlier, they take you there, you sit, and they take this one in the back. That is partiality in the church. We are practicing partiality. We are dividing people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But God looks at all souls equally. Because God's love is for all of us. It's for all the church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are supposed to perfect holiness in the fear of God. Not dividing one another. Not dividing the church. God's love must be perfected among all believers. Hallelujah. Because
Amen.
When Jesus comes, he's not going to ask you, oh, you, which denomination were you in? Oh, which church did you go to? Or who was your pastor? No, this is not going to happen. The judgment of God is too hot. And everyone is going to be judged according to what we have done. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We'll be judged according to the fruits we have bear. Hallelujah. We must have complete love in the likeness of God. Complete love. We must have God's love by embracing those who love us and those who does not love us. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us go to the book of Romans chapter 5, verse 8. Romans 5, verse 8. Love, love, love. The love of Christ is what he's expecting us to have. All of us, without segregating, without, you know, judging, but complete and true love. Just get that. Romans chapter 8. Romans. Okay. Romans chapter 5 verse 8. Alright. Here it says. Romans 5. But God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Much more than having now been justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. For if we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his son. Much more, having been reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That God demonstrates his love toward us in that while we were all sinners, Christ died for us. We were all sinners. No one was perfect. But because of Jesus' love, he brought us with all our filthiness, with all our dirt, with all everything we know the way we were, and he brought us. Now here we are, and we are the same people judging one another. Why people are fighting? One, because of jealousy. Because if this one sees so-and-so is doing something, and God is using him, because it's not us who does the work of God the way we want. It is God who uses us. So if this one God is using this one to do something, this one gets jealous. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
And we know jealousy comes from the devil. Hallelujah. Jealousy is not from God. This one gets jealous. This one gets envy. This one gets angry. This one gets, you know, hatred. This one is unforgiveness. All those things, they join together. That is why the church is scattered like this. Because there is no love. But the Bible says that when there is love, hallelujah, love covers all sins, a multitude of sins. Hallelujah. You know, when you love someone, when you have true love with someone, you will not hate them. Hallelujah. You will not even have jealousy for them. But you will embrace whatever opportunity, whatever they do, you will love them, you will support them. Even if it is a ministry, we are supposed to support one another because by doing that, we are serving God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 As Jesus gave the apostles the commandment to love one another, as he had loved them. So we have to love one another. This is one thing Jesus told the apostles. He told them everything, but he said, love one another as I have loved you. Because of love, he died for us, you know, and he reconciled us back to God. It wasn't easy for Jesus to do that. But because of that true love, why can't we forgive one another today? Why can't we accept God to change us, to give us the heart that can that is full of love, the heart that is full of forgiveness, no matter what people have done to us? It is required of us to love and to forgive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If someone have done something for heaven's sake, for thy soul's sake, for the kingdom of God's sake, we have to forgive and have to love. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Christians love in unity, in truth. Hallelujah. That is what the Lord requires us to do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And hallelujah. I love you all. And shalom. God bless you all.